And welcome back to the Talking Money with Nozi podcast. I'm your host, Nozi, and today we're diving into a topic that's very important but often misunderstood, and that is your credit score. Whether you're trying to build a good credit score or recover from a bad one, this episode is for you. Let's start with the basics. What exactly is a credit score? Simply put, a credit score is a number that shows how likely you are to repay borrowed money. It's like a report card for your financial behavior. Your credit score is measured on a scale, usually from about 300 to 850, and the higher your score, the better. It is based on things like how much debt you have, whether you pay your bills on time, and how long you've had credit. A good credit score is usually above 670. This means you are seen as a low-risk borrower. A bad credit score is usually below 580. This means that lenders like banks, etc., might see you as a high-risk borrower, making it harder for you to get loans or credit. So, how do you build a good credit score? Here are some simple steps. Tip number one, pay your bills on time. This is the most important factor. For example, if your debit orders are set for the 25th of every month, they must be paid on the 25th, not on the 30th. Late payments hurt your credit score. Tip number two, use credit wisely. Don't max out your credit cards. Try to keep your balance below 30% of your credit limit. This means if you have a credit card with an allowance of 10,000 Rand, don't use the entire allowance. Use 3,000 Rand or less. If you max out your credit card, you're viewed as a risky client who is heavily reliant on debt, and it can hurt your credit score. Tip number three, check your credit report. You can go online and check your credit report on websites like ClearScore, Experian, and TransUnion, for example. The reason for checking is because mistakes can happen. Make sure that there are no errors on your report that could be bringing your credit score down. Why is having a good credit score so important? Here are some of the benefits. Benefit number one is when you borrow money, a good credit score can help you get lower interest rates, which saves you money in the long run. Benefit number two, whether you're applying for a home loan or a car loan, a good credit score makes it easier to get approved. Benefit number three, did you know that your credit score can even affect your insurance rates? A higher score can mean lower insurance premiums. Now, let's talk about what happens if you've got a bad credit score. With a bad credit score, lenders see you as a risky borrower, so they charge you higher interest rates. You might struggle to get approved for loans, credit cards, and even rental leases. Guys, these days they check your credit score. Bad credit can limit your financial options, making it harder to achieve your goals, like buying a home or starting a business, for example. Personally, I use my credit card to build my credit score. I use it to pay for my monthly subscription services, for my video editing software, and my online store, and it costs me less than 2,000 Rand in total. Then I pay it back in full every month. So guys, here's the golden rule. Never carry a negative balance on your credit card. Credit cards are for people who have the money to pay them off. It is not for those who cannot afford it. So guys, a credit card is not for you when you are broke. Access to credit can be a blessing or a curse depending on how you use it. The wrong use will destroy your credit score. So be very careful. If you're dealing with a bad credit score, don't worry. It's not the end of the world. Here's how you can start rebuilding it. Number one, focus on paying off your debts, especially those with high interest rates. Number two, if you don't have any credit at all, maybe you can consider getting a credit card or a small loan that you can manage easily. But be careful, guys. Do not get carried away. You do not need mountains and mountains of debt to build a credit score. Number three, make payments on time. Set reminders, or rather just automate your payments so that you don't miss your payments. And guys, do not reverse your debit orders. That will just hurt your credit score. Number four, be patient. Rebuilding your credit score takes time, but every small step gets you closer to your goal. Your credit score is an important part of your financial health, and it's something that you can control. Whether you're building from scratch or recovering from mistakes, the key is to stay disciplined and make smart financial choices. Thank you for joining me on this episode of the Talking Money with Nozi podcast. Remember, your credit score doesn't define you, but it can open doors or close them depending on how you manage it. So take charge of your credit today. Until next time, keep making those smart money moves and stay financially empowered.